name is Michael Welch-Bey. I am originally from Charlotte, North Carolina. As a matter of fact, the corridor that we're focusing on, I grew up on that corridor, in the old Commons Avenue area. Unfortunately, I guess I could say unfortunately in one way and then maybe in another way, it wasn't so unfortunate. But I was a soldier. I spent 3 tours in the United States Army, a member of the 101st Airborne Division. Unfortunately, on my way to Iraq, a moment of indiscretion caused me to be incarcerated for 23 years of my life. But as I was speaking with Steve, and I really mean this, you know, I'm not bitter, I'm better. You know, and my motivation comes, you know, my mother, she was a nurse in the old Charlotte Memorial Hospital for about 27 years. And I was the product of a single parent family. My mother raised her children. She went back to school and became a nurse. And my mother passed away fighting to get me released from prison. So as a memorial to my mother's death, I decided that I would be the man that I knew that she knew I was. And that's where my motivation comes from. You know, everything that I do, every step that I take, is for her. And so that's basically who I am and why I am. But I'm very excited about being here. I'm very excited about the experience that I've had. I'm very excited about the tremendous support that I've received from so many individuals since returning home. I've been home for about 4 years, and you know, I must give all props to my lovely wife who believed in me. You know, we grew up as children. I haven't seen in 35, maybe close to that many years. We reconnected, and you know, I started going to church, and she started, you know, helping me reintegrate back. You know, you can imagine the serious undertaking that I had after being gone for 23 years. But I would like to give her a special honor for helping me through that.
My name is Travis Williams. I'm from Annapolis, North Carolina. I currently live in Concord, and I see myself inching closer and closer to Charlotte. I love the buzz. Our co-working spaces there will be headquartered there. I currently work here. So I expect to be living here in the near future. I'm the analytical mind of the group. I love numbers, I love charts, I love graphs, I love whiteboards and long, drawn-out presentations, especially when I'm giving the presentation. while I was away, I learned Spanish. I love people. Love self-improvement, learning, helping others improve, helping others' vision and mission. I first came in contact with the criminal justice system as a young teen. Most notably, when I was 16, I come home from playing basketball one day, and there were 2 Secret Service agents waiting on me. And you know, since then, one of those agents have made it faithfully to every court date I've had to tell the judge that I was a menace to society. He should not let me out. And I've done over 7 years in prison, been in over 14 institutions, from max, state, federal institutions. And I'm still, I just recently got out in 2016 from federal prison, and I'm still on federal probation. And as Patrice was talking about supervision, it made me think, and I just realized just standing here that ever since I was 17 years old, I have always been under the foot of the criminal justice system, without a gap in there. Ever since 17, there's always been some kind of supervision, probation, intense, house arrest, incarceration. However, This is something I've been looking forward to more than anything. One of the best things to happen since I've come home. There's also another reason to celebrate in a couple of weeks. Come February 13th, a probation officer will be giving me a call to let me know that I will be officially done with federal probation. Time is up.
Sheltered as a kid, and really didn't get to venture out because I was looked upon to be the man in the house. And when I did finally get a chance to get out, and I became a teenager, I got pretty wild. And forgot about school, forgot about all my upbringing and what they taught me as a kid. And pretty much started doing my own thing. And proceeded to get me into trouble. I always wanted to be a businessman. I became one. I sell the right type of product. I was pretty good at it. And each time I got arrested, I always felt like I could come back out here and do it better the next time. And I did. And I enjoyed the jewelry, the women, the clothes, all that. And I always ended up in the same place, losing everything I had. But I finally got my act together, and I really changed my life over and gave my life to Christ. But during my playing times, I had a habit, you know, I started to use the products that I was selling. And it kept me from totally committing myself. Well, I should. I mean, I taught Sunday school. I was assistant superintendent of the Sunday school classes and a little bit of everything. I was a steward. But, you know, I was living a lie. And eventually, it caught up with me. And I left. I didn't want to be a hypocrite, so I left church. And I kept my job. I was able to keep a job. Longer than I ever had for 8 years. But it took me losing my family, my house, my wife at the time, like I said, my job, and having someone tell me they didn't want me anymore because of my drug use and what I had turned into. And I lived in a shelter for a year and a half. 2008, I was able to get back on my feet. That year and a half, I went to drug rehab, went back to school, got a degree in engineering. But my record kept me from getting that job that I thought I was going to be able to have. You know, I got frustrated. But I believed in God. I said He was going to take care of me. I stopped trying to do things. I got out of my own way. Right, Bob? I got out of my own way, and I let God, you know, lead the way. And in one of my job interviews at Goodwill, I met Rob, and he said he had a program that was coming up. It wouldn't be soon, but if I held on and kept in touch with him, that sooner or later, he was going to get what he needed so I could join the program. And I did, and thank God I did. So I'm getting to be a businessman, but I'm going to do it the right way this time.
Well, this, you know, the transition, one of the things that I knew after doing this much time as I did, well, not necessarily the amount of time, but being an ex-felon, that it was going to be extremely difficult for me to, you know, at one time I was, I served as a med tech in the United States Army. I mean, I worked in the laboratory, hematology, microbiology, serology, blood bank, you know, and that was something that I excelled in. Got to meet a lot of important people at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. But I knew that that was over. I would not be able to get a job doing that anymore. So I did everything that I could do to prepare myself for some type of entrepreneurial type of path, because I knew if I did get a job, it was going to be a menial job. It wasn't going to be the job that I wanted. So, you know, I had vision. I had visions for a long time on what I wanted to do from a business perspective. And one of the most interesting things about those visions that I had was pretty much incorporated with the same structure that I experienced when I came to City Startup Lab and the REEP program. It's been very difficult for me. You know, when I got out, I worked for $7.25 an hour and saved every dime until I could buy me a truck, I could start me a landscaping business, and, you know, and then it went from there trying to get a job. When I enrolled in this program, I had a job working 12 hours a day, and I asked for permission.
How many hours a day?
12 hours a day. I asked for permission to cut my schedule back or allow me to come to this program, and, you know, of course I was blatantly denied. So believing in everything that I had heard and everything that I had envisioned myself, I said, well, I'm going to leave this job, and I'm going to go to this program, and I'm going to finish it, because this is what I want to be about. I know what it's going to take for me to make it. And that was very difficult. I thank my wife again, because, you know, being without a job, having to do side jobs, having to try to make their income meet, she believed in me as well, and, you know, we got through it. And I knew once I had made that sacrifice by leaving my job to become a part of the REEP program, that there was nothing else to do but finish, and finish strong. So I had an opportunity to, you know, meet, and I'm still on parole too. Just submitted something to the courts to remove me from the role. Hopefully that will take place, not hopefully, but that will take place in the next 2 months. I should be off the road as well. But the most difficult thing for me coming home is really understanding how to navigate and reintegrate into society that has no consideration, no real second chance programs, no forgiveness for individuals not only that have did their time, but are doing quite well upon returning home, trying to do the right thing. And that was the most extremely difficult thing for me. You know, my wife can tell you, you know, I was turned away from here, I was turned away from this place, that place, and a lot of the new jobs that I applied for, you know, I was certainly qualified for the jobs, but, you know, that ex-offender subculture or sub-tag that you have on you is very, very unforgiving. And I just want to say, and I'm done really, that I think everyone that has been associated with you here, everyone that has, you have provided, the mentors, the accountability coaches, everyone, that has allowed me not only to realize that I can be whatever it is that I desire to be, irrespective of how many barriers are before me, if I just focus, believe in myself, and accept the wisdom and knowledge from all of these individuals that you have, you know, put around yourself. It has been the most transformative opportunity that I've had in many, many years. And I'm just grateful to be a part of the City Startup Lab and the REEP program.
And I could echo almost everything Welch-Bey said, but employment. Coming home, you know, you're going to get turned down. Just get prepared for it. You have people without records, they get turned down and they're still looking. So you should expect that. Just keep getting up, trying it again. But after the 100th time, you know, knowing I'm certified, I'm proficient in C++, bilingual, I'm proficient in office suite, like various other skills, communication, soft skills, and the best I can find is minimum wage cleaning jobs. That gets disheartening after a while. That's definitely one of the bigger challenges.
Hey, you gotta go to work after this.
I do. I do. Clean machines. Third shift graveyard. Which I'm grateful for that. And I was grateful for those minimum wage jobs when I got home. And similar echo, saved all my money, bought a car, got in place, you know. But again, without the support, I have my best friend here tonight, Ashley. Amazing support, family. You know, I don't see how that would have been possible, honestly. The support is crucial. It's just like it's necessary. You have to have that. So yeah, the biggest obstacle I would say is difficult. Just coming back out, navigating, and figuring out all these things. You've been planning for so many years. I'll get a place here. I'll save up this much. And all this looks good on paper until you get out of here, and it's things are more cloudy.
Yeah, I just have to agree with these guys. Even after going back to school and got my degree, even there, I still was turned down behind a 30-year-old fellow. And none of the big companies, but nobody was hiring, because you know, you have to go in people's residence in order to fix their health conditions or whatever. And I just didn't qualify. You know, it was disappointing. Frustrating. I tried to do it on my own for a while. I did okay for a while, you know, but it wasn't some paying things, you know. It's too many jobs, too much time between jobs. And eventually, you know, frustration came. I ended up going into a federal program for senior citizens. I'm 63, so I qualified, and best they could do was give me the media job, trained for 20 hours a week, which one of the jobs I ended up going to was at Red Cross, refurbishing blood tubs. And I met my future wife, and thank God I met her there, because it wasn't long after that I was getting support for the housing I had, getting a rent voucher. And while I was living, the government decided to sell out, and when they did, I guess they went through all of the paperwork that was involved with the occupants. They found that I had a record. They're going to throw me out of my head. And anyway, if it wasn't for Miss Carol Welch, my future wife, things worked out well.
Yeah.
I ended up getting a job, though. Cook the chicken and Popeyes for almost minimum wage. It's not a job. You know, I know I'm way more qualified for what I'm doing, you know, what I'm doing, where I'm going. So I can't wait to get started. I want to thank you, bro. You're a man of your word. You lifted me, you know, my spirits. You made me start using my head. And, you know,
Man,
thanks for answering all my calls and all the sponsors, coaches. meetings on Saturdays. D, Mr. Kennedy, y'all just don't know. It's giving me a lot of hope. I don't know how many more years I got left, but they're gonna be some good ones.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
Program has been very, very beneficial. The subject matter, extraordinary subject matter. I commend you on the many volumes, voluminous amounts of information that you had to study. But it gave us a serious foundation and an integral understanding of the business model and all of those things associated with learning how to successfully run a business, the principles and all of those things. And I'll forever be indebted for that. But the most difficult part, probably in all fairness, was someone that's returning home from prison and needs a job in order to secure housing, in order to, you know, just trying to get the stability and foundation. It was extremely difficult to complete the program without any additional aid or consideration or outlet to aid and assist with the economic plight. And unless you just really was all in, you know, it was a heck of an endeavor. But other than that, you know, all good.
So I entered the program. I'm 1 year away from getting my business economics degree. So I come into the program knowing everything about everything as far as business is concerned. And, you know, Mr. Rock quickly showed me that I didn't. So there was a lot to learn. There was, he kept challenging us. The program was great. You know, anytime we thought we had it figured out, this was our best work. He made us look at it again, look at it from a different angle. We learned about real research, meeting with people, you know, having interviews, customer discovery, customer validation, like things I've never considered in business. And I know a lot of the challenges that echo Welch-Bey again were around the whole survival versus thrival. You know, we want to do this, we want to be a part of this thing, but I need my bills paid, I have to go to work. And I know a lot of the ones that did not make it, that was some of the things that they were facing. And again, that goes back to our support. One thing we never looked at in the what went right, what went wrong, is if you notice that the ones that did not make it here, may not have had the same significant other, the positive significant other that we have tonight here. So that is a very big deal. So, excellent.
Yeah, I thank God for Carolyn, because I don't know what would have happened. Reef would have had to go, you know, because I would have been homeless again, you know, shit. Had my back the way she did. And the material, you know, it was over a lot of people's head, Mr. Rock. Not that you pounded us with, but it was kind of a bit much, you know, for people just coming off the street, you know, and getting back into the groove of learning and studying and reading, because it took me a while. If it hadn't been for Trey, I'd still been lost, you know. But overall, it was a great program. Man, keep doing what you're doing, because there's a lot of people out there doing what you got. Really.